Hi guys, I'm Dr. Nath and we'll have a short discussion based on an MCQ. So let's go through this MCQ. Kidney transplant recipient presents with asymptomatic rise in creatinine 1 year after renal transplant. Serum BK virus nucleic acid testing is 11,000 copies per ml. Next step is A. Reduce dose or discontinue MMF. B. Start leflunomide. C. Do urine examination to look for decoy cells. And D. Do allograft biopsy. So with the background of this MCQ, I'd like to discuss shortly about BK virus nephropathy, which is an important MCQ topic and clinically relevant topic, and highlight the important points. So talking about BK virus belongs to a family of viruses called polyomaviruses. Three polyomaviruses are known to be pathogenic to humans, that is the BK virus, the JC virus and the SV40 virus. We are going to discuss about the BK virus now. So the BK virus causes upper respiratory tract infection in childhood, and more than 80% of adults have evidence for prior exposure to the BK virus. And this virus, after causing a URTI in childhood, persists in the urothelium. So that's our problem. So with the advent of more potent immunosuppressive therapy, mainly remember two drugs, tacrolimus and mycophenolate mofetil, the incidence of BK virus nephropathy has been increasing over the last 25 years. So there is a sequence of events that you have to remember. First, the patient develops a wide urea, that is virus in the urine. Then there is a viremia, where it increases in the plasma, and then it can cause a nephropathy. So when it causes a nephropathy, it does cause graft loss in about half of the cases, 50% of the cases. And therefore, here's an MCQ point. BK virus is the most common infectious cause of graft loss, chronic allograft loss, late graft loss. Okay, so you have to remember that as an MCQ point. And what does it cause in the kidney? It causes a interstitial nephritis. It causes an interstitial nephritis. Less commonly, it can cause a ureteritis, which can lead to a ureteral stenosis. Okay, which can lead to a ureteral stenosis. So most of the cases of BK virus nephropathy will occur before 2 years post-transplantation. 95% of cases occurs 2 year post-transplantation. The median given in Brenner's textbook is 9 months. So mostly you see it in the first transplantation year, as in our MCQ scenario. So what can you do to diagnose a BK virus? So the first one is called wide urea. So you can check for the nucleic acid testing in the urine, where you can see the BK virus. And in resources which are limited, where you cannot do nucleic acid testing, you can look for something called decoy cells in the urine. Okay, so that's an MCQ. Decoy cells in the urine is an MCQ. So it's not seen in the normal light microscope, it is seen under the phase contrast microscope, and there are four phenotypes of decoy cells that are described. Okay, so A, B, C and D, there are four phenotypes, like you can see in the picture. If you look at A, it has a gelatinous ground glass nucleus. Yes, we'll mark a star there. Or you can have a halo, okay, nuclear halo, like in cytomegalovirus. Or you can have binucleate, as you can see, or vesicular nuclei. So these are the four phenotypes of decoy cells. And decoy cells are seen in BK virus infection. So that's what you have to remember. So then you have viremia, you can do that. And then you will have viremia. You will have viremia. So you can check the plasma for BK virus nucleic acid material. Okay. And in the allograft biopsy, if you were to do an allograft biopsy, you can have patchy interstitial nephritis. You can have intranuclear inclusion bodies in the tubular epithelial cells. And number three, earlier, it used to be difficult to differentiate between acute rejection and BK virus nephropathy because both used to occur simultaneously. But with the emergence of the SV40 immunoperoxidase stain, it is now easier to distinguish between BK virus nephropathy and acute rejection. So remember, SV40 immunoperoxidase stain. So going on to the treatment for BK virus nephropathy, the truth is that there is no treatment for BK virus nephropathy. Before that, let's just see what the KDIGO guidelines say. So this is from KDIGO. Okay, This is from KDGO. KDGO suggests that all patients, all kidney transplant recipients, be screened for BK virus monthly for the first 3 to 6 months after transplantation, and then every 3 months in the post transplantation year, whenever there is an asymptomatic rise in creatinine or after the treatment for acute rejection. These are the four scenarios where they suggest testing. The level of evidence is pretty high too. And whenever there is a persistently high, that's what is very important. Whenever there is a persistently greater, you have to note the word persistently greater than 10,000 copies per ml in the plasma, then you can consider reducing the immunosuppressive therapy. Okay, you can consider. So the persistently high is important, and you have to remember the number greater than 10,000. Please remember the number greater than 10,000. So the mainstay of therapy in BK virus nephropathy is to reduce the immunosuppressive therapy. So we already described two drugs, tacrolimus and MMF, which have to be either discontinued and switched to another drug. Preferably, TAC can be converted to cyclosporin, and you can introduce an mTOR inhibitor in place of the antimetabolite MMF. Okay, so sirolimus can be used because tacrolimus and MMF appear to activate BK virus replication. There are three other drugs which have been studied in small trials. They are sidofovir, leflunomide, and ciprofloxacin. Especially leflunomide is being increasingly used in practice in the context of BK virus nephropathy, but there are no guidelines which recommend their treatment. Okay, so guideline recommendation is only to reduce the immunosuppressive therapy. So in this background, let us go back to the MCQ. So option A is reduce dose or discontinue MMF, which is not the answer. Because A, we are not sure if this asymptomatic rise in creatinine is because of BK virus nephropathy only. It is true that when the level is more than 10,000, okay, as in this scenario, that the risk of BK virus nephropathy is high, okay, it signifies probable BK virus nephropathy, but only persistently high levels warrant a reduction in dose or discontinuation of antimetabolite MMF. So that is not the answer. And second of all, this asymptomatic rise of creatinine can be an acute rejection, it can be calcineurin inhibitor toxicity, or any other reason leading to increase in creatinine. So we cannot just by plasma levels reach a diagnosis of BK virus nephropathy. Leflunomide, as I told you, is not mentioned in any guidelines to be started as a part of treatment for BK virus nephropathy, but it is a drug being increasingly studied for the treatment of BKVN. And look for urine examination decoy cells, and this comes, you know, behind the timeline. Okay, this is one of the first steps. In resource limited settings, you can look in the urine by phase contrast microscope for decoy cells to see if the patient could be having a BK virus infection. Okay, but this is not the answer. So the answer is do allograft biopsy. Confirm the diagnosis of BK virus nephropathy first before going on to treatment. So the answer to this MCQ is D, do allograft biopsy. So I hope you learned a few points about BK virus nephropathy. I'll see you in another video soon. All the best.